There are several verses in the Quran describing how God created our world. The 41st chapter contains four that have received a lot of attention by commentators comparing the Quran and scientific understanding. Verses in the Quran can often take multiple meanings. Let's take a fascinating new look in light of the latest scientific understanding. قُلْ أَنْتُكُمْ لَتَكْفُرُونَ بِالَّذِي خَلَّقَ الْأَرْضَ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ. Say, would you indeed deny him who has created the earth in 2 days? In a previous post, we discussed how days of creation are variable lengths of time in the order of millions of years. So I'll frequently use the word eons instead of days. This raises a question. If the periods of creation are of variable time lengths, why did God say two instead of just one? Can the formation of the earth be divided into two significant events? Amazingly, scientists now believe that a second major event occurred that had significant impact on the earth becoming what it is today, and on the ability for life to survive on it. 4.5 billion years ago, the sun and the planets of our solar system all began forming at the same time from dust and gas. Earth's formation coincides with the formation of the sun and the seven other planets. Earth began as dust clumping together to form rocks and asteroids, which joined by gravity to become planetesimals that were about 1 kilometer in size, which collided and grew into a protoplanet. A protoplanet is a mini planet that undergoes internal melting and has a differentiated interior. And after about 15 to 20 million years, Earth became a full-fledged planet. Let's consider that the first of the two eons that God talked about. What might the second one be? Well, when the Earth was 60 to 175 million years old, something very significant happened. To help explain the composition of meteorites and rock samples from Earth and the Moon, scientists theorized, using a computer model, that a second protoplanet, called Theia, which was about the size of Mars, tangentially struck Earth at an angle of about 45 degrees, and at a velocity of about 33,400 kilometers per hour. On impact, Theia's dense core sank right into the Earth's and added more iron to Earth's core. Earth's mass and volume not only grew from the additional matter, but the energy from the impact turned Earth's surface into molten rock hundreds of kilometers deep. The impact also sent debris and gas into space, which formed a disk around our planet. And that disk later coalesced into our moon at a distance 5 times closer to the Earth than it is today. No matter how the moon was created, without it, many scientists believe that life on Earth might not be possible. So the moon formation could explain why God said he created the Earth in 2 eons, not one. And if so, the 2 eons together spanned about 200 million years. Apart from lighting up the night, how does the moon contribute to life on Earth? The moon causes oceanic tides, which have significant importance for oceanic life and weather. For example, tides carry floating plants and animals between breeding regions and deep water and circulates nutrients that the ocean plants and animals need to survive. Even more importantly, the gravitational pull of the moon slows Earth's rotation. Without the moon, a day on Earth would be 6 to 12 hours long instead of 24. The moon also helps to stabilize Earth's axis of rotation at 23 degrees relative to the sun, which ensures stable yearly seasons and somewhat predictable climate. And finally, the extra iron that Theia contributed to Earth may have given our planet a stronger magnetic field. Before we consider the next verse, science tells us that after the Earth's surface finally cooled and hardened, the next major occurrence was volcanism, or the creation of mountains above the Earth's surface through volcanic and tectonic activity. Volcanoes helped to create Earth's first atmosphere by emitting gases along with the molten magma during eruptions, And tectonics, the process in which the crust of the Earth shifts around in plates, causing earthquakes, also produces other mountains through a process known as subduction, which causes rocks and the molecules trapped in them to be driven into the Earth's interior, where they are heated, creating new volcanic eruptions. The repeated construction and destruction of the crust in the early Earth regulated the level of CO2 in the atmosphere. Now let's go back to the next verse in the Quran, verse 10.
For he placed mountains above its surface and blessings and a means of subsistence on it
in four overlapping days for those who ask. Subhanallah. The creation of mountains through volcanism was in fact the crucial next step for the life-enabling developments to follow, including Earth's first CO2-based atmosphere. We will continue with the next two verses in the next episode. Please come back and continue with me on this topic in the next video. I have posted links to related information in the description. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and share.